you care about. On your lunch hour, Jay Recker and Zach Blobner. JNC. Today at noon. Now back to the Pat and Aaron Show. Mornings on WDAE and streaming live on the free iHeartRadio app.
Pat and Aaron Show, 95.3 WDAE, AM 620. It's time now for the Pat and Aaron Show Injury Report, presented by Florida Orthopedic Institute in partnership with Tampa General Hospital. Let's go to the hotline now, where our good friend Dr. Charles Knofsinger joins us. Dr. Knofsinger, thanks for joining us again. How are you?
Good. Good morning, guys.
Well, let's get right into it here, because we got a week and a half until the Super Bowl is in Arizona, and you got the Chiefs and the Eagles and Patrick Mahomes. High ankle sprain going into that championship game. I'm sure they did a lot of work on it leading up to it to get him ready for that game, but he made it through. It looked like it got a little worse and it was wearing on him as the game went on. How much will the 2 weeks of rest, because we know it's not completely healed, doctor, especially with the high ankle sprains, we've spoken about this before, how will the 2 weeks help him in preparation to get as close to normal as possible?
Yeah, it'll help a lot. He's got a really good athletic trainer. So at college and pro level, we have athletic trainers that literally their whole focus is on returning the athlete to play. And he'll get a lot better. You know, he won't be normal. High ankle sprains actually take about 4 months to fully heal.
But, wow.
Yeah, guys, I know. It's not a fun injury. And he'll be, you know, with the adrenaline and all the care and the taping, he'll probably be 85%, but that's probably, I'm hoping it's enough. I'm a Chiefs fan myself.
85% of Patrick Mahomes is better than 95% of the rest of the league.
He is good. He is good. You know how the NFL is, though. You're at the absolute top level, so it's a wait scenario.
No doubt about it. And Aaron, I think you mentioned as the game went on, it seemed like the injury got worse. I think it was also as the game went on and as the drugs wore off,
yeah,
right?
The drugs went bye-bye.
No question.
You know, when you talk about rehabbing from an injury like this, first of all, what kind of things do you do when it's short of surgery, right? What kind of things do you do in that rehabilitation process? And if you're working with someone like Patrick, right, where you know they've got to try to use that ankle, even if they shouldn't, even if you'd rather they don't, you know they have to try to use that ankle sooner than you would ask them to or you would want them to. Is that process, is any of that rehabilitation different? Do you do any kind of different exercises because that guy's being rushed back into action?
Yeah, so there's a cold compression system that applies kind of continuous pressure from your toes up to your thigh and cold at the same time. That really helps eliminate a lot of the swelling, which can be the source of the pain in this injury. And then we also have pretty wild new things. There's something called blood flow restriction, where you basically have two computer-controlled tourniquets, and you fire the muscle under these computer-controlled tourniquets, and it helps return the muscles, for instance, in his calf, much faster than they would otherwise. And then there's even other wild things, like there's something called an Altergy. It's a treadmill that basically suspends you over the treadmill, so you put just enough weight to fire the muscles, but not enough to cause damage. So he'll be doing all that kind of thing.
I want to ask you about Travis Kelce, because it was very odd. He appeared before the championship game on the injury report with back spasms. He played, maybe affected by them, didn't have as much production as we've seen from him in the recent past. Pat, my buddy over here, Pat, is dealing with back issues himself. When you hear spasms, what exactly is Travis Kelce probably dealing with here?
Yeah, so, you know, with his position, where you're using the muscles in your back to either take down or hold off the opposing player, you can tear those little muscles that are run along your spine back there. And then it doesn't even have to be a bad tear. And then the little sensory nerves and the nerves that control them get trapped in that little tissue. And it's brutal. I've had it myself. You know, it sounds like it's something minor, but those back spasms can be a real challenge. Now, in terms of treatment, it's the same thing. You know, you do massage, you do some what's called electrical stim on those things, and then there's some medication. But, it can be a really challenging problem to get over, even though it seems like a minor issue. So I thought his recovery sounded like it was good, was my impression.
I was very interested slash confused slash surprised when I saw the report that Brock Purdy is going to miss 6 months, regardless of whether or not he has surgery on his torn UCL. How common is that? How many injuries are there where your recovery is going to be basically the same regardless of if you have surgery or not? And also, why is that? And why would you opt with surgery if you're going to have the same recovery time either way?
Yeah, that's a really interesting problem. So that tear that he's got is what baseball pitchers get. So if you're a Tommy John surgery, that's what we're talking about. But so there's a newer version. So if you tear your ulnar collateral, which talk about bad luck, huh? If you tear your ulnar collateral these days in a non-pitcher, like a football player or a wrestler or something like that, you can do an ulnar collateral repair. So that's what they're going to do. They're going to repair that thing, and then they put in what's called a internal brace. It's a special little support device you can put in there that allows the ligament to heal. And so he'll actually be back playing in 6 months. Whereas typically if it was a pitcher, you know, they're not going to be throwing full gas till a year. Yeah. Now, as to being non-op, I don't think anybody in their right mind these days would non-op that injury. Because what's going to happen is as soon as he goes out and gets even a minor hit like he had before, he's going to be out again. So I don't know why they said 6 months non-op. I mean, you can do, let's say you had a partial tear, you could inject this stuff called PRP in there, and then he could be back as fast as like 3 months. So I think that statement was more for the media than it was for the athlete, in my impression.
The body is fascinating, Dr. Nofsinger, and I'm realizing it. I never broke. I'm such a wuss.
Here comes the finger again.
Hold on, Pat. All right? Just give me a second. I have never broken anything in my body, and I broke my fingertip, and I went over. Dr. Nydick took care of me, put me in a splint, and it was like, hey, 6 to 8 weeks, you'll be good. And I'm like, that doesn't make sense. Like, you're splinting up. You're taking the splint off to go in the shower. But when I got the x-rays after about 7 weeks, the finger was healed, and I was like, I'm going to go play some golf. And I went and played some golf, and, like, my finger did not hurt. It's amazing to me how I mean, you think 6 weeks, all right, that's a long time. It really is not for that bone to really heal, and that's a minor injury. I don't even have a question. I just want to tell you, the body's fascinating. I'm learning it.
Yeah, no, I'm with you, man. I mean, and yeah, I'm glad it worked out. Did you end up just playing without the buddy taping, or did you?
I tried the taping, and I couldn't hit naturally with it, so I took it off just to feel it out. Did it get a little swollen after I iced it up? Yeah, but like the function was there. I shot at 86. What's up?
Nice.
So yeah, like it was so bizarre to me after the feeling I had when I broke it and how much it hurt to me being able to play golf 7 weeks later. The body is fascinating.
Yeah, it's amazing.
That's how I'm going to end it. That's all I got there. I was going to say for Landon. Well, let's end it with this. Landon Dickerson dealing with a hyperextended elbow. He's expected to play. Yeah. We saw something similar with our Donovan Smith here in Tampa Bay. What impact will that have on a guy like Landon Dickerson?
Zero. Once the adrenaline hits. So when you hyperextend your elbow, you stretch the ligaments out and the capsule in the front of your elbow. So, you know, you have a balloon around every joint that kind of keeps the fluid in and then kind of keeps it stable. And with that injury, when the adrenaline hits, it's going to have zero effect on him.
All right. Well, listen, we will certainly keep our eyes on these injuries and catch up with the Florida Orthopedic Institute and Tampa General Hospital next week. For now, Dr. Charles Nofsinger, always love having you on the show. Thanks for joining us today.
All right. Appreciate it, guys.
Good luck to your Chiefs, okay?
Thanks,
I mean that.
Yep.
Oh, I mean that, too. F the Eagles, dude. F the Eagles.
I'm with it. So on the text line, you guys, stop being mean to me. All right, I know.
Aww,
you may not care about my dumb little finger. All right? I was just trying to say how the body is fascinating.
Oh, your dumb little finger.
I know.
Well, the vitriol.
The things I have to deal with. It's unbelievable. The Pat and Aaron Show Injury Report presented by Tampa General Hospital in partnership with Florida Orthopedic Institute, providing you access to one of the top orthopedic programs in the nation. Schedule an appointment today at floridaortho.com. And may I add that...
You may.
That it is so easy when you go there. I love that. The convenience of it. Like, I'm a guy who is very impatient, especially when I have things to do. So it's a well-oiled machine. Whether it's the x-rays you have to get and then see the doctor after, they move you along.
Not like us.
Seriously, we're late. All right, but they move you along. Florida Orthopedic Institute, book that appointment today, floridaortho.com.